K-12 Gallery in Tejas, Teen Educational and Joint Adult Studio, is a serious place for creative fun.
Hello, my name is Janine Kinnison, and I'm sitting here today with Regina Dixon, and she's involved with K-12 Tejas. How did you get involved?
Maybe about 15 or 20 years ago, I started as a volunteer at K-12 Gallery when they were on 3rd Street. For their Saturday morning children program.
Were you attracted to the children, or were you attracted to the art, or to both?
Probably both, because okay. I enjoy art and I enjoy working with children quite a bit. Okay.
I want to talk a little bit about you. How did you become an artist?
Well, earlier my mother was a kindergarten teacher, and I would have to always help her each year to decorate her classroom. And so I was very excited about what colors to use for kindergartens to stimulate their mind. And that was one of my main projects, as to how to decorate a kindergarten class with either alphabets or numbers or blocks or squares or triangles, something that they can visualize in their world of art, to expand their world of art. So in other words, I would like the kindergarten class to be able to expand a child's vision of what the world of art may be to them.
So your mother was an artist?
No,
or she was a kindergarten teacher?
She was a kindergarten teacher, plus she had a lot of artist ability.
Okay, so she was one of your influences.
Yes.
Any other family members or any teachers as you grew up in high school, college?
No, I didn't study art in college, but I did have a lot of artists in the Dayton area that I was inspired by.
Can you name some of those?
I have three I can think of that comes to mind. Trish McKinney. I took several of her watercolor classes with her. That's when I started to do watercolor projects, and took several workshops classes with Trish. And the second one was Sharon Govern. She's an artist at Kettering Arts, it's an art school in Kettering, and she does very vivid, nice colors, bold colors. And then also Merlin Hart, she does very nice watercolor crafts, greeting cards that inspired me to start painting greeting cards. And I do all of my Christmas greeting cards by hand.
But they're beautiful. Can you talk a little bit about the medium you use? You said watercolors
I use watercolor quite often, and then I use acrylic paint.
Something that you've developed over time?
Mostly, the acrylic has been something because I started using just mostly watercolor, and then I expanded myself to use acrylic paint.
What do you paint? What is your picture?
Well, I like to paint flowers, landscaping, ocean sceneries, the sky. I just like to paint anything that's a part of my world that I can share to other people.
When we've talked before, you talked about abstracts, though.
Yeah, I do. I've done abstracts. Abstracts are a little tricky at times, so I have done some abstracts.
Why are they tricky?
Because seem like to me I'm more of a structure person, but abstracts you could be more free and loose when you do abstracts. And it really is not. If I'm painting a red barn, it's a red barn. But if I'm doing abstract, it can be a number of values, different values or different tones in the structure. But a barn is like a red barn, but an abstract is you can just do anything.
Realism versus abstract.
Right. Yes.
Where do you see yourself as an artist in 3 to 5 years?
Let's see. Probably still enjoying art quite a bit and having a lot of fun with art. Having some more children projects, because I usually host, in the past I have hosted in my backyard art parties for children, where we have crafts and painting and raffles, and just I have a 4 hours, just a lot of fun. So I may have another art party for children in my backyard.
Regina, do you have any final words or philosophies for those that may be thinking about becoming an artist?
As an artist, we have many different experiences and many different expressions through different mediums or the opportunity that it has given most artists to express themselves. It's a way of giving back to the community and being a part of the community.
Well, you're very involved with Tejas, right?
Yes.
So that's part of the community.
Yes.
So I understand that.
Yes.
Thank you for taking the time to talk to me today, and good luck with your art.
Oh, thank you.